Settle down.
Everybody's here.
Guys, our time here is very limited, so I need this group right here to stand up and move into this row, please, right now. What are we going to do right now? Stand up, and move in. We're
no
about
one's
to do
gonna
has
get
never
hurt.
Been
no
done.
No one will be hurt.
At TEDx, in the history of
not
TEDx
not a lot of people
ever.
Will be hurt.
Move in. Nice and tight. Pack it in tight. You're not moving fast enough, guys. Body's touching.
It's like a pretend
body's
fire drill.
Body's touching. Really close to each other. Fantastic. Guys, everybody else that's sitting, I need your vocal cords. I need the vocal cords to be involved, all right? So right now, this has never been done before. We have a birthday in a house.
Oh, shit.
And what we're gonna do is, while our birthday boy is surfing the crowd, and that's body surfing. Everybody else from top of your lungs is gonna sing "Happy Birthday, Brogan." All right, okay. Sir.
I'm ready? Taking a selfie video.
As you are.
You ready? This might not work.
Step.
I don't know if my mic works.
Hands up.
They
everybody,
said
hands
didn't
up.
Have time for this.
Hands
I'm going.
Up.
Ready?
All right. 3, 2, 1. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Brogan. Happy birthday to you. Yeah! Bring him down.
He's coming back.
This is not appropriate. None of this is appropriate.
Oh, buddy.
Happy birthday,
that was
buddy.
Awesome. Thank you.
Oh, my bad.
All right. Didn't see that coming. I got shoes on. Guys, gather ourselves. Calm down. I'm Brogan, this is Boyan, and today we're gonna tell you how to build a movement. We're the co-founders of November Project, a free grassroots movement in 16 cities in North America. Yeah. All right. After rowing together for 4 years at Northeastern University, Boyan and I, our post-college life actually took us away from Boston before it brought us back in our late 20s to reunite us as friends, and to dial into some of the shared vision we had and what we wanted the rest of our lives to look like here. Wanted to stay fit, wanted to enjoy Boston, and wanted to do it for free.
On 11-1-11, Brogan and I decided to, we're gonna get together and we're gonna use everything this beautiful city has to offer. We're gonna run around the river, we're gonna run up and down the hills, we're gonna run some stadium stairs, and we're gonna have so much fun. We're not gonna pay for fitness because people don't pay for fitness. But what we're doing is we created this thing. As former college athletes, we used to track everything. And we created this Google Doc that we named November Project so we can track our progress. So we went from that November all the way through winter, and we came through spring as better friends, as stronger athletes, as fit people. So we're like, I think we're onto something. I think we're doing something right. So let's start inviting our friends. So we signed up for some races. We're like, let's start inviting people. So we use power social media, and we had one recruit. One person showed up. We're like, whoa. She showed up, and we're like, yes. 100. Later that summer, we had 100 people. By the end of 2012, we were on average about 300 people at every workout.
Oh. Yeah, we did. All right, so let's break it down. So the spring of 2013, we brought on two new cities that had their own November Project tribes. The first was my hometown, with my older brother leading November Project Madison, Wisconsin. The second was San Francisco, California, led by a good friend of ours from college and from November Project Boston, Laura McClowski. Fast forward not even a few weeks, months really, April 17th, 2013. So Wednesday, immediately following the Boston Marathon bombings. That morning, we had nearly 500 people in a single workout here in Boston. A lot of you were there. And it was an experience that we couldn't really compare to anything else. So unlike anything outside of workouts, anything in our entire life, really. People showed up, especially locals, to avoid the media circus, right? Remember that? The media circus had just come to town overnight. People showed up to share their pain, I mean, literally in tears. And some people showed up just because they knew, in a November Project tradition, that they'd be able to share a free hug, right? For whatever reason they showed up because they knew we would be there, and they knew that there'd be a workout. Whether they wanted to do it or not, they knew we would be there. And walking away from those uncertain faces that morning, we recognized a few things. One, this thing was bigger than us. This thing was bigger than our friendship. And this thing was, I don't know, it felt like it needed to be executed in these other two cities, but also in cities all over the world. It was a community that people needed. Pretty heady. Fast forward to the fall of 2013, there were seven cities in the party when Edmonton, Alberta, Denver, Colorado, San Diego, California, and Washington, D.C. all joined in the party. Word of mouth was spreading. Local, national, international news, media, they were all hyped, right? December issue 2013 of Runner's World magazine not only told our story, but it put us on the smack dab front cover, and overnight, the athletic industry was spiked using the name November Project. Fast forward through another winter, we land in the spring of 2014 in 16 cities, and this movement is on a roll.
Which brings us to now, to today. Actually, just recently, a couple weeks ago, we had 1,500 people at a single workout. We had, on Wednesday, all over 16 cities, we had 4,000 people working out. That one day, over 4,000 people working out. It started with just two of us. But we're not here to tell you about our history because we can go for hours.
Days, even.
Decades. That's not the point. We're here to tell you what our secret sauce is, what you need to do, what's the recipe to build a movement. Ingredient number one, inclusiveness. Our members range in age, in fitness levels. We have elite athletes and we have recent couch potatoes all working out together. I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with Harvard Stadium, but it's kind of secluded, inclusive space where everybody, even the fastest people and the slowest people, are all working out together and they're all pushing and encouraging each other. It's pretty powerful. You don't have that anywhere else. And if you think about it, the inclusive part comes with if you line up 30 butts on the line, starting line, go. Everybody starts racing. You have 30 different speeds, right? Add another 60, all of a sudden those 30 people are running faster. The people that are in the back, they're pushing people that are in the middle of the pack. And the middle of the pack are trying to catch up with the top. And top of the line, those middle of the pack guys are not going to catch up with me. And all of a sudden, everybody's running faster. Even though you think, you know what, I'm not competitive. That's not true. Just the sheer power of the mass. The mass will push you forward.
That's inclusiveness.
That's inclusiveness, yeah.
Let's see. Ingredient number two is to have a really badass PowerPoint presentation. No, that's not it. I made that up just now. It's my birthday. I'm excited. Sorry. That wasn't on here.
It's all good.
I didn't write that. Ingredient number two for the recipe for your movement is strong culture. Strong culture. We as leaders will always be there. Not late. Not weather dependent, we're weatherproof, and our commitment is unwavering. So your rain, your sleet, your hail, hot, hot humidity, whatever it may be. All the snow, right? All the snow and ice that brings traffic to a standstill here in Boston and cities around the world cannot stop November Project. In fact, what is it, 3 years? 3 years of workouts, and we have canceled zero workouts because of weather. Yeah. Strong culture. That's strong culture. This ingredient, strong culture, it's important. How about this for strong culture? At November Project, if someone asks you, hey, are you gonna be at the next workout? Seems like a pretty fair question, right? Maybe, maybe not, right? November Project members are not looking for, you know, some wishy-washy, half-assed, maybe, I don't know. November Project members want a verbal commitment. They want to drive accountability. They want you to be there. Our workouts, unlike your gym, are better when they're packed. They're better. They're always better. So when someone asks you at November Project, will you be there on Friday? They're looking for what we call a verbal. All right? It's a piece of our culture. A verbal means that you are going to be there. And so you say, yes, I will be there. I'll see you Friday. Now, what if you break that verbal? Well, at November Project, at November Project, we have on our website what's called the We Missed You page. The We Missed You page is essentially the bus that our members throw each other under to document not only the photos of their friends or recent enemies, but the details of how they broke their promise, right? And we didn't build the We Miss You page as a way to torment. We built it to drive accountability, right? We really want you there. I want you to keep your word. When your alarm clock goes off, maybe the very last layer of accountability has to do with the We Miss You page. That's strong culture.
Number three, fierce. Now, fierce, definition of fierce is heartfelt, powerful intensity. Fierce is not the person that is the fastest. Fierce is not the person that is the strongest. Fierce is the person that pursues their goals no matter what the obstacles are. This young lady, she came to the workout. First time she came to the workout. She did a few sections at Harvard Stadium. I don't know if everybody's familiar. Harvard steps are about yay high. They're big. And there's 31 of them. And then there's 37 sections. And there's a lot of things going on. It's overwhelming. It's hard. It's intense. And she came and she did a few sections and she called it quits. And it was hard. It was hard. But she said, "No, I will finish 37 sections no matter how long it takes me. If I have to go through the night, I will finish it without stopping." So she had some setbacks, she had some injuries, but 4 months after she showed up for the first time, she was able to complete her first full tour. And we were just as excited because we thought that her accomplishment was just as badass as if you were to run a 220 marathon. That's fierce.
Yes, yes. Yes, fierce. The ingredient number four is fun, new, and creative. In a world of smartphones and smart tablets and smart screens of all sizes that are clearly dominating not only our eyes, but our ears and our emotions, you have to be fun. You have to. You have to be new, and you have to be creative. You have to. It's a must. It's a piece of our recipe, and it needs to be in yours. Fun, new, and creative, right? So starting this minute today, using the power of the internet, we're launching what we call November Project tickets. We'll probably end up in a little bit of jail time for this, but
pass them on.
These are meant to grab people's attention, right? Just like that We Miss You, we're not trying to torment anyone. We're trying to grab your attention and make you do something that's real, right? So when you see these, whether it's on our website or it's the first few rows of today's presentation, the November Project ticket is supposed to make someone stop and make someone hopefully have a better day. We urge you to write something kind or something funny on the back of these tickets and leave them for someone to find. It could change their day. It could change their life. But if nothing else, These tickets, as you explore the city you live in, will make you feel fun, new, and creative. Right? That's it. There's four pieces of the recipe. There they are. They're for you. Take them. Add them into the mixture, the concoction of whatever you're trying to do, right? This is not about November projects. It's not about a workout. It's bringing us here to tell you today how to build a movement. So change the parts, equal parts, add some sea salt, whatever you want to do. But we hope that these ingredients end up in whatever movement you are trying to build. And as we close every single November project gathering,
have a great day.
Thank you. All right. Thank you.